I get started, I just want to say that I have only been working with the Pecanic Estuary Program on these habitat restoration efforts for a little over a year now, and there are a lot of authors listed on here that have been working on these efforts a lot longer than me and really deserve much of the credit. So a little background on alewife, just for anyone who may not be familiar with this species. Alewife is a diatomous fish. It spends the majority of its life in the ocean, but migrates to fresh waters to breed. Its native range is from the Carolinas to Maine and northward to Newfoundland. The alewife and the very similar blueback herring are often collectively referred to as river herring. But on Long Island, where I work, alewife is the more dominant species and has been the focus of our restoration efforts. So alewife migrate into coastal waters and eventually up into freshwater streams in late winter. Their movement into fresh waters is governed by changes in water temperature. Their preferred spawning habitat is slow-moving, calm waters. Following breeding, the adults will immediately migrate back out to the ocean, but the juveniles do remain in the freshwater and estuarine environment for the first several months of their life before returning to the ocean. And alewife and other diatomous fish play very critical roles in our coastal ecosystems. Their movement from salt to fresh waters is particularly important for transferring ocean-derived energy into the estuarine, freshwater, and upland environments. And alewife is also a very important forage fish, providing prey for numerous species throughout its life cycle, including several commercially and recreationally important fish, birds, and mammals. Alewife did once support a pretty large commercial fishery, but commercial catches have dramatically declined, as shown in the graph, and abundance is near historic lows. The decline of alewife is due to a couple of reasons: one, overfishing and bycatch in commercial fisheries, and two, due to loss of access to their critical freshwater spawning grounds due to the construction of dams on many freshwater tributaries. So the Pecanic Estuary Program has been trying to do its part to help the alewife population by restoring access to their critical freshwater spawning areas in our watershed. The Pecanic Estuary Program is one of 28 national estuary programs around the nation. It's funded by the EPA under the Clean Water Act, and our estuary is between the North and South Forks of Long Island. So on Long Island, the two largest alewife spawning runs do occur within the Pecanic Estuary watershed. Those are denoted by the red arrows. The largest run is at Alewife Creek in Southampton. In Alewife Creek, there are no major obstructions to alewife migration. The second largest spawning run is the Pecanic River, which runs from the town of Brookhaven East to the headwaters of the Pecanic Estuary. Unlike Alewife Creek, this river has been heavily impounded. And the blue stars there just denote other places within our watershed of confirmed alewife. So because of the importance of the Pecanic River for alewife spawning habitat and the heavy impoundments on this river, our restoration efforts have been heavily focused here over the past couple decades. Until recently, there were 6 dams along the length of the Pecanic River preventing the upstream migration of alewife and other diatomous fish. 2 fish passage projects have been completed so far. These are denoted by the green triangles, the first at the first barrier on the Pecanic River, and then another fish passage has been completed further upstream. Fish passage projects are also in progress at all of these other impoundments, with the exception of the most upstream dam. And I'll be talking about each of these projects as we go through the presentation. Once all of the fish passage projects that we're working on are completed, this will restore access to over 300 acres of habitat for alewife and other diatomous fish, and we hope that will result in an increase in the alewife population on the Pecanic River. So efforts to restore alewife habitat in the Pecanic began back in the 1990s. From the beginning, there's been strong community support for these efforts. By 2000, funding had been secured to purchase and install an Alaska Sea Pass at the first impoundment on the Pecanic River, the Granville Park Dam. That steep pass was placed at the dam during at the start. alewife breeding season and then subsequently removed at the end of the spawning season from 2000 to 2009. So that steep pass did successfully pass alewife, but a more permanent fish passage solution was sought by the partners working on this. And the design that was decided upon was a nature-like fishway or a rock ramp. And this project was completed in 2010. And not only does it allow for the up and downstream migration of several fish species, but it's pretty nice looking. And this opened up 24 acres and 1.5 miles of river habitat. So since that rock ramp was installed, a volunteer alewife monitoring program was initiated on the Conic. The purpose of this monitoring was to detect the presence of alewife upstream of the new rock ramp, to determine the timing of the alewife, the Conic alewife spawning run, attempt to provide some spawning run abundance estimates, and to collect some baseline biological data. So three sites on the Conic River are observed for spawning alewives, and those are shown in this map here, the Grand Jewel rock ramp, and then the immediate two upstream barriers, the Woodhole Dam, which is on the Little River, the first major tributary to the Conic River, and then the Upper Mills Dam, which is the next barrier on the main stem of the Conic River. And this volunteer effort in the Conic has largely been led by Byron Young, who's a retired New York State DEC biologist, who now volunteers his time at the SeaTac Environmental Association, nonprofit on Long Island. The SeaTac Environmental Association also leads a Long Island-wide alewife citizen science survey. So each spring we do recruit citizen scientists to help us with these monitoring efforts. So much of the effort has focused at the Woodhole Dam, which again is this one right here on the Little River, and that's because the majority of the fish seem to congregate here. I have a little video to show you what this looks like. So there's a whole bunch of alewife below Woodhole Dam. To get an idea of how many alewife are here, alewife around the edges of the pool at Woodhole Dam are counted, and then in the shallow center of the pool, and that number then gets extrapolated based on the entire size of the pool. Alewife counts are also made at the Upper Mills Dam, which is that next barrier on the main stem of the Conic River, but much fewer alewife have been observed there. And then counting alewife at the actual Grand Jewel rock ramp has proved to be a little bit difficult just because of the logistics of that site, and the alewife seem to run at nighttime there. For our biological sampling data, the alewife are collected with the cast net and sexed and measured. And we do take scale samples from a subset of fish for future age analysis. All fish are subsequently released back to the water. And we do hold some nice educational events here every year, which is a great way for us to get the community involved in our monitoring and restoration efforts. So these are the count observations for alewife at the Woodhole Dam from 2000 to 2017. And what you should take away from this table here is that the peak run times for alewife in the Conic River in most years seem to occur during the first 2 weeks of April. And also, as you can see, alewife have been observed as early as late February and as late as the end of May. So based on the these count numbers, we extrapolate those numbers to come up with some overall spawning population estimates. So these are estimated numbers. These are pretty crude estimates, but they at least do provide us some indication of the spawning population size here and help us to look at variations from year to year. I do want to note that the 2011 data is actually based on some limited video monitoring data. A video monitoring counter system was placed at Grand Jewel, at the Grand Jewel Park rock ramp. In 2011, it was only functional for about half of the spawning period though, and video monitoring has not really been done since then because it didn't work out that well. There was heavy fouling of the video equipment, the visual observations have been what we've, our best bet. We are still trying to explore other options, though, for getting more accurate alewife spawning estimates. And 2013 seemed to be our largest alewife spawning run. Since then, things have been a little bit more variable. And then moving to the biological data, this is a table of the lengths. So far, we have measured over 7,600 alewife. The average length for males tends to be around 260 millimeters. Females are a bit larger. They have an average length of 270 to 280 millimeters. And then we also have done age analysis for the years 2011 to 2013. This age analysis was done by the New York State DEC Hudson River Fisheries Unit. The ages range from 2 to 8, with the majority of fish being ages 4 to 6. We have continued to collect scales since 2013, but we haven't been able to do the age analysis for those scales at this point yet. So, because of the success of the Grand Jewel fish passage and also the attention that's been brought to the alewife population due to our monitoring efforts, this has really helped to spur along other fish passage projects on the Taconic River. And fish passage is coming soon at the Woodhull Dam, where all these alewife seem to be congregating. Final engineering designs for fish passage have been completed here, and we have secured funding to construct this fish passage. This is going to include accommodations, Neal and Steep Pool fish passage. It also includes an American Eel passage. And we also have funding to implement a video monitoring and fish counter system here. So hopefully that works, and maybe that will provide us with some more accurate estimates of our spawning population size. So coming soon. We're also working on fish passage at the Upper Mills Dam, which is that next barrier on the main stem of the Taconic River. A feasibility and fish passage alternative analysis was completed back in 2011, and we're currently working with a contractor to get some more specific engineering design plans, but no fish passage option has been decided yet here. This is a little bit of a more complicated project because we have a lot of players and stakeholders involved in this one, and also downstream of the Upper Mills Dam, USGS does maintain a concrete weir that measures the flow of the Taconic River. Unfortunately, this also does impede passage, upstream passage for alewife. So we need to come up with a fish passage solution for both the dam and the weir. And one of the options that we're looking at for this site is a potential nature-like fishway, like was done at the Grand Jewel Park Dam. We've also been talking to our stakeholders a little bit about dam removal. If there's any site on the Taconic where we think dam removal might be possible, this is the site, but folks are still pretty hesitant about that option, so we'll have to wait and see. The next barrier upstream of Upper Mills is the Forge Road Dam. Fish passage plans are also in the works here. This dam is in pretty bad shape, so repairs are needed, and at the same time, the plan is to implement a fish passage structure based on some previous conceptual design plans that the Taconic Estuary had funded for the site. Again, though, the final fish passage option has not been decided upon, but this is an example of some of our conceptual designs. Upstream of the Forge Road Dam is the Edwards Avenue Dam, and this is the other fish passage project that has been completed on the Taconic River. This was a New York State DEC-owned dam, and this dam was failing, so when they did repairs to the spillway here, they went ahead and put in fish passage structures. An Alaska Steep Pass, which is shown on the right side of that first picture there, was put in to aid alewife passage. An American Eel Pass was also put in on the left. This project was completed in 2006, and while the fish cannot yet access this due to downstream barriers, it will be waiting for them when those downstream fish passage projects are completed. And lot of great progress on diatomous fish habitat restoration in the Peconic, and we're excited to keep moving forward. And it's really been a collaborative effort between the Peconic Estuary Program and the multitude of partners listed here whose support that we are really grateful for. I'm happy to take any questions.